Welcome to this instructional video series that will take you through the application of the Lumalore electroluminescent coating system. First, some basic theory. We all remember the basics of circuitry. Take a power source like a battery, run it to a light bulb, and then back to the battery. Bingo, the light goes on. This is similar to how Lumalore works, but Lumalore is slightly different than a light bulb. Think of Lumalore like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, where the bread is conductive and connected to an alternating current electrical source. When charged, the bread creates an electric field that excites the peanut butter, which then subsequently causes the jelly to emit light. If you make your sandwich right, voila, you've created light. And if you carefully follow the instructions in this video, you can make the sandwich, your sprayed-on Lumalore light bulb, correct every time. The system consists of five main components: a backplane layer, a dielectric layer, our LumaColor layer, the busbar application, and our conductive topcoat layer. First, backplane material. The backplane is a highly conductive, low-resistance material that allows the current to be supported across the entire lit surface when applied in an even and consistent manner. Next is our dielectric. The dielectric does two very important things. First, it acts as insulation and is applied over the entire backplane evenly and consistently to ensure there is no burning or shorting. Secondly, it assures the current is being distributed evenly across the surface to produce even light. The color of the light is a function of our third coat called LumaColor. LumaColor is a very large particle material and will be sprayed under black lights to see where the color is being applied. The next application is our busbar. The busbar is a conductive layer of backplane material that provides a zero resistance path for better current distribution to our final layer, the conductive topcoat. The conductive topcoat layer is the final conductive element that, once charged, allows Lumalore to emit light. Top it all off with a coat of your favorite automotive speed clear, and you're in business. In the videos that follow, we'll go through all the steps necessary to get lit, using the Lumalore training kit you have received. In the Lumalore training kit, you'll receive the following: 4 ounces of our backplane material, 4 ounces of dielectric, 4 ounces of LumaColor, 4 ounces of conductive topcoat, JB Quick Weld, 1 flat clear plexiglass panel, 1 speed tank, 2 small electrical inverters, 2 18-volt converters, 2 male spade connectors, 2 male connectors, 1 foot of copper tape. An important first step is to put on rubber gloves and wear them throughout the entire process, both for your protection and to protect your objects from any oils or particles that might come from your hands and fingers. Next, we'll be scuffing, cleaning, and taping off your flat plexiglass panel and your clear speed tank. Both objects should be thoroughly cleaned with isopropyl alcohol and wiped dry. The plexiglass panel and speed tank should be thoroughly scuffed in all directions using a red Scotch-Brite pad. This will create a rough surface, better suited to hold our paint. When finished, both should no longer have a glossy finish and will be thoroughly scuffed, like you see here. Use a tack cloth to remove any small particles that may be present from the scuffing process, and then clean and dry one last time with isopropyl alcohol. Now you're ready to begin taping and masking your objects in preparation for the backplane layer. Using 3/4-inch masking tape, carefully mask off the entire perimeter of the plexiglass panel. You will need to leave a portion of the panel free of tape. This is where your electrical connections will go. To avoid nicking or cutting the surface, we recommend you use this method to cut the tape. Rest a razor blade on the tape at a slight angle, and then pull the tape against the blade for a nice, easy, and clean cut. Once finished masking, you'll need to make a clean edge for the backplane material using 1/4-inch vinyl tape, like so. Use the same cutting method to leave room for the electrical components. Take the time to run your finger along the vinyl tape to make sure that it is free of wrinkles or bubbles that could affect your finished piece. Lastly, finish cutting your vinyl tape to allow for your electrical components, which includes a piece of vinyl tape on the very edge and wrapping over the edge of the panel as illustrated here. You'll go through the same steps to prepare your speed tank, only you'll start with the vinyl tape and then masking tape along the base of the tank. Like you did on the plexiglass panel, you'll need to leave a notch free of tape to allow for electrical connection. Once completely masked and scuffed, you're ready to spray. As the size of your backplane area increases, the size of the connection site should increase proportionately. If the size of the backplane area is double the example here, then the connection site should also be doubled in size. This will allow the power to spread evenly throughout the backplane and not be funneled or choked, passing from a small connection site into a larger backplane. Our first step is the application of backplane layer. To review, the backplane layer is the sprayable conductive layer that forms the base coat of any Lumalure application. The application of the Lumalure system should be done with an automotive-grade HVLP spray guns equipped with a disposable cup system like the PPS cups shown. This allows the gun to be stored upside down while not in use and will help to avoid clogging the nozzle. This is critical because in order for the application to be done successfully, you'll need precise control of the amount of air pressure you're using and the spray pattern. Before opening the can of backplane material, shake vigorously to ensure proper mixing of the backplane as the material may have soft settled. When adding the backplane material to the paint cup, be sure to strain it through nylon 120 mesh or 125 microns filter. Once your paint is loaded into your spray gun's cup and is ready to spray, keep the spray gun in an upside down position to keep the airway clear of paint. The spray gun must be placed in an upside down position to keep the airway clear of paint. This is important. Our paint is heavy and it can clog your gun if not stored this way between coats. To prevent any settling of the Lumalure material, you'll need to be constantly agitating your paint throughout all spray applications. With the spray gun set to about 20 to 25 PSI, spray your tape plexiglass panel with a broad fan pattern, about 8 to 10 inches away. You'll need to use a 50 to 75% overlap pattern as illustrated here, meaning each pass of your spray gun will overlap the previous layer by about 50 to 75%. By holding your object up to a light source, you will be able to see the backplane coverage between coats to better determine if more coats will be needed. We recommend applying two coats and then take a multimeter reading after it is dried. Here we see the technique for spraying compound shapes like the speed tank. Notice he uses constant motion to ensure even coverage. On subsequent coats, he focuses on the same even coverage, but sprays the opposite direction of the coat he is covering. Allow a minimum of 15 to 30 minutes for the backplane to dry before moving on to any other material application, but do not exceed 8 to 12 hours of dry time for the backplane. Once dry, you'll need to use an electrical multimeter to measure the ohms or electrical resistance of the backplane. As shown here, the ohms reading should be 10 ohms or less. This means that electricity is able to flow freely and with minimal resistance across the surface of our object. If the ohms exceed 10 ohms, you'll need to apply at least one more coat of backplane to the surface. When finished, carefully remove all vinyl and paper masking tape by pulling the tape back upon itself. Pulling the tape up at 90 degrees or less can damage the painted areas. The final, very important step is to gently sand down the edge where the backplane and the tape met. You'll notice a small peak here. This needs to be sanded down using 1,000-1,500 grit sandpaper to allow proper insulation when the Lumalure is powered on. Next is the application of the dielectric layer, the second component of the Lumalure system. To review, the dielectric layer serves two critical purposes.
It provides a layer of insulation that covers the backplane area and extends to support the bus bar. This ensures that no burning or shorting occurs.
Secondly, it assures that electrical current is being evenly distributed over the backplane to produce even light. Before spraying, you'll need to mask off the electrical connection site on the backplane with the green masking tape. This will ensure that no dielectric will come in contact with the connection site. Make sure your tape extends about 1/8 inch beyond the conductive backplane to further ensure no contact is made. It is important to thoroughly and completely cover this area as it will be masked for the next three material applications: the dielectric, the Lumicolor, and the bus bar. In preparation for spraying, you'll want to use the same shaking and straining method used when preparing the backplane material. Before opening the can of dielectric material, shake vigorously to ensure proper mixing of the dielectric, as the material may have soft settled. When adding the dielectric material to the paint cup, be sure to strain it through nylon 120 mesh or 125 microns filter. Once your paint is loaded into your spray gun's cup and is ready to spray, keep the spray gun in an upside-down position to keep the airway clear of paint.
The dielectric must be applied in the correct thickness evenly across the entire backplane, as well as the surrounding areas that will house the bus bar in a later step. Adjust the pressure on your spray gun to 20 to 25 psi. First, start by outlining the perimeter of the backplane with the first coat of dielectric as shown here. This ensures that the edges of the backplane will have enough dielectric to provide proper insulation. Once complete, apply the first coat of dielectric about 6 to 8 inches away from the surface by using the same 50 to 75% overlap technique from before. Spray each coat in the opposite direction by crisscrossing each coat as shown here. Remember, it's very important to be constantly agitating the paint while in the process of spraying to prevent any settling. For most applicators, two coats of dielectric should be sufficient. Once two layers of dielectric have been applied, the panel should look like this. You can see the proper contrast between the backplane and the surrounding areas, and no copper color of the backplane is visible when dry. If any copper color of the backplane is visible, then apply another coat of dielectric or until the copper color of the backplane is not visible when dry.
Once again, be sure to use constant motion and follow the contours of the object you're painting to properly coat compound shapes like the speed tank. When complete, your objects will be an off-white color with an even matte finish. Allow the dielectric to dry a minimum of 15 to 30 minutes before moving to the next material application, but don't exceed 8 to 12 hours of dry time. Lumicolor is the layer of the Lumalure system that determines the color of the light expressed by our finished application. Lumicolor is sprayed under blacklight to see where the color is being applied and to ensure the coating is even and consistent on the entire area. Shaking the Lumicolor vigorously is critically important when preparing the Lumicolor material, as the components of the Lumicolor are extremely prone to separation. Use the same basic method used when preparing this material as you did when preparing the previous layers. When adding the Lumicolor to the paint cup, be sure to strain it through nylon 120 mesh or 125 micron filter. Once your paint is loaded into your spray gun's cup and is ready to spray, keep the spray gun in an upside-down position to keep the airway clear of paint. The application of the Lumicolor must be done under black lights. The ultraviolet lights cause the Lumicolor to glow, This allows you to accurately observe and ensure the proper, even, and thorough coverage of the two required coats of LumiColor. Because the LumiColor is so prone to separation, it is especially important on this step to be constantly agitating the spray gun throughout the spray process. As before, you'll need to crisscross each coat, and on your speed tank, you'll need to use constant motion to ensure even and thorough coverage. If, after two coats, the LumiColor appears uneven for any reason, a third coat can be applied to even out the coverage of the LumiColor layer. Once the LumiColor glows evenly under the black lights, allow your object to dry for a minimum of 25 to 30 minutes on this application, before moving to the next material application. Do not exceed 8 to 12 hours of dry time. The bus bar and our first layer, the backplane, are the two layers that are directly connected to your power supply and distribute electricity to the LumiColor system, creating light. The bus bar creates a perimeter around your backplane and is critical for even, consistent, and bright light.
The bus bar is the same material as our backplane conductive material and provides a low resistance path for better current distribution to the following layer, our conductive top coat. The backplane, dielectric, and LumiColor must be carefully masked off in preparation for the bus bar.
Begin by taping around the outside edge of the backplane with 1/4-inch green masking tape. Be sure to completely cover the border and overlap by at least 1/8 inch as demonstrated here. Then run another line of 1/4-inch tape along the border of your panel. The area between the two lines of tape is what will become your bus bar. Next,
use paper to mask over the LumiColor area, as tape will leave a residue scar that will show when lit.
Finally, run a piece of tape along the edge of your panel and let it wrap over the edge. This is to prevent further shorting or minor electrical shocks when under power. Make sure the area around the backplane connector has at least 1/8 inch of space around it to make sure the bus bar never comes in contact with any part of the backplane connector. A reminder, this is the area that you taped off before the application of your dielectric layer.
All bus bar areas should have a 1/8 inch gap from the outside diameter of the backplane. Bus bar should never be directly above any part of the backplane. This gap prevents a short.
You'll do the same process with your speed tank, taping off a ring around the base of the tank that will become the bus bar. Again, make sure that the tape is at least 1/8 inch outside of the backplane, just like the panel, so the bus bar does not overlay the backplane when sprayed. And as before, always be careful to protect the electrical connection points on the backplane. In the spray booth, you'll need to change the pattern on your spray gun from a broad fan pattern to a tight bullet pattern. This will help to keep the paint in a tight line around the perimeter of your plexiglass and the base of your speed tank.
The bus bar should have a minimum of 2 coats of backplane material before testing the ohm reading with a multimeter.
Allow the bus bar to dry for a minimum of 15 to 30 minutes before proceeding to the next material application, but don't exceed 8 to 12 hours of dry time. When complete and dry, you'll need to test the bus bar strip with the multimeter, and the ohm should read 10 ohms or less. With that reading, you have successfully applied the bus bar.
After proper ohm reading is met, remove all masking tape. The tape from the bus bar might leave an edge just like the backplane did. This edge will need to be removed by sanding away from the backplane area. Very important to not allow any bus bar material to smudge onto the LumiColor where it covers the backplane.
we now need to run power to the plexiglass panel and the speed tank. This will provide the electrical current that will power the Lumalure system. All necessary wiring components are included in your training kit.
Begin by scuffing the metal tab connectors on both sides with a Scotch Brite pad. This will allow the backplane material to adhere properly. Once scuffed, clean the metal tabs with isopropyl alcohol. Backplane material will now need to be added to the metal tabs of the connectors. Secure the connectors down with tape to begin the application. Then take a small amount of backplane material and a small paintbrush and brush the metal tabs on the connectors for the flat panel.
This will ensure that the connections will be as conductive as possible, and let dry for 15 to 20 minutes before applying to the connection side of the panel. Place your connectors tab side down on your bus bar area and your backplane area respectively, and tape them into place with thin masking tape. Once the tabs are taped in place, use your multimeter to test connectivity and ensure that electricity flows freely to both the bus bar and the backplane. Simply put the meter prongs on one of the connectors and one on the backplane or bus bar tab. If you have a reading with the meter, you have conductivity. Swap the meter prongs to test the other connector and test for conductivity. The next step is to use the included JB Quick Weld to secure the tabs to the panel and to the speed tank. Use about an inch of material from each of the two included tubes of Quick Weld, a 1-to-1 ratio, and begin to mix them together on a disposable surface. Here we use a small piece of cardboard and a section of popsicle stick to mix with. Mix until the Quick Weld is a uniform black color. Apply a dab of Quick Weld to each of the tabs to permanently secure them in place. Important, make sure that these two pads do not come in contact with one another, which would cause a short. Once these are dry, apply more of backplane to the tabs in the area that was covered by the tape holding them in place. The connection points will look like this when finished. You'll go through the same process with the speed tank, only you'll thread the wires through a small hole drilled into the base of the speed tank in the area that was taped off for the connection points. You'll then fishhook the wires into place on the backplane and the bus bar respectively, securing them in place with the included copper tape. Finish by securing them in place with JB Quick Weld as illustrated on the plexiglass panel on the backside as shown here. Once the connectors are secured in place on the backside with the JB Weld, apply backplane material with a small paintbrush over the copper tape onto the previously painted backplane and bus bar. Once all connections have been made and secured, it's time to reapply masking tape to the backplane connection site in anticipation of application of a conductive top coat. Important:
make sure the tape is overlapping the exposed backplane tab by at least 1/8 of an inch.
If not done properly, this will create a direct short after the conductive clear is sprayed and the Lumalure will not light. Once the connection site is properly taped, plug the inverter into the panel and make sure the inverter is switched off. If the inverter is on, it will give off a slight hum. The conductive top coat layer is the final conductive element that, once charged, allows Lumalure to emit light. Before opening the can of conductive top coat material, shake to ensure proper mixing of all the components. If shaken too much, the material will foam. When adding the conductive top coat material to the paint cup, be sure to strain it through nylon 120 mesh or 125 microns filter. Once your paint is loaded into your spray gun's cup and is ready to spray, keep the spray gun in an upside down position to keep the airway clear of paint. For this step, you will need to have your panel and your speed tank wired for power. To avoid damaging the inverter, it is critically important that you completely connect your object to the inverter before turning it on.
After spraying one medium wet coat of the conductive top coat,
you will speed dry the object with a heat gun. We recommend spraying with lights off. While drying, you will notice light begin to emerge from the outer edges where the bus bar is located. As the heat gun continues to dry the conductive top coat, the light will begin to shine brightly across your entire object in the color that you chose from your Lumicolor. If there is no burning or discoloration after fully heat drying, this step is complete. In this video, you will learn how to apply the encapsulating clear coat and what we call a blackout coat to your plexiglass panel and speed tank. These steps are included to protect the Lumilure system and give your projects the professional, finished look that you'll be proud to show off to fellow painters and, more importantly, potential customers.
Now you'll apply two coats of your favorite automotive speed clear to the panel and speed tank. We use Speed Clear as it dries fast, which will lock down the system quickly. We don't use Heavy Build Slow Dry Clear as it flows and levels out on the surface. It can pull the conductive top coat as it flows out.
Following the proper instruction for mixing, drying, and recoat for best results, make sure to encapsulate any and all layers that were previously sprayed to include the edges of the panel, speed tank, and connection sites. Once all clear, coat layers are properly dried on both objects, you will need to test the objects for proper insulation. You will begin this process by testing your objects for any shorts or other electrical problems that may be present. This is accomplished by gently running a bare finger along the edges of your illuminated surface. Any sparks or little shocks that you may observe are a sign of an electrical problem and should be corrected before proceeding. This finishing step involves three main components and starts with two coats of automotive clear, then a coat of black to cover our bus bar, then a final two coats of automotive clear. In preparation for your blackout, you need to thoroughly scuff your panel and speed tank, including the connection points. After scuffing, the panel and tank will need to be gently wiped with a tack cloth and cleaned once again with isopropyl alcohol and wiped dry.
In this step, you will mask off and completely cover your connection points while they are connected and powered with JB Quick Weld for strength and a consistent, neat, finished look.
Make sure your JB Weld, when fully applied, covers the entire connection site to include the metal connector and a small portion of the wire. You can use a small amount of water when the JB is still a bit wet to smooth out and make a clean, even surface. After about 2 minutes of dry time, you can remove the masking tape, leaving behind a neat black pad where your electrical connections are. You'll go through the same process with your speed tank. Start by scuffing the JB Weld that was previously applied and wipe clean with a tack rag. Make sure the inverter is plugged into the panel and simply turn to the on position. Next, you'll need to once again mask off your illuminated area in preparation for the blackout layer or bus bar cover-up coat with 1/4-inch vinyl tape. Once the entire perimeter of the light is taped off, fill in the illuminated area with masking paper, as this area will not be covered up by the blackout when sprayed. Mask up any areas that were left exposed when placing the masking paper over the illuminated area. You'll go through the same process with your speed tank. To start this process, make sure all tape around the edges have not lifted up, and your tape lines are slightly inside of the lid edge, so when blacked out, there are no dead spots that do not light, and that is not blacked out. The blackout coat will be sprayed with your objects under power. This will allow you to effectively black out the bus bar with black automotive paint. Once dry, remove all tape material from the entire panel. When doing this, make sure the tape is pulled back on itself to avoid any pull-up on the blackout areas. Finally, spray on your final two coats of your favorite automotive grade clear coat to both the panel and speed tank. With that application, you have successfully completed the entire Lumalure system. Congratulations!
Congratulations! You are now able to handcraft light using Lumalure light emitting coating. This video series provided the basic information necessary to light the two sample shapes in the Lumalure starter kit. Visit our How to Lumalure page on lumalure.com for more training resources, including detailed videos on specific aspects of the Lumalure application process. These resources and videos will advance your skills and knowledge of Lumalure application beyond the basics covered in these initial training videos. Contact your Lumalure distributor or reseller directly if you have any questions about the Lumalure application process.